This is your News 4 update, powered by the Bomarito Automotive Group.
Thank you for choosing News 4. Let's get things right over to Steve for a look at your forewarn forecast.
Yeah, freezing rain, sleet, and icy mix coming our way tonight into early tomorrow morning before it melts off. So it's a winter weather advisory in the light blue for St. Louis, 9 p.m. to noon. But for the metro, I think the timing is really midnight to about 7 a.m. to worry about slippery travel. If you're not driving in those hours, I think you're going to be okay. Just be careful walking outdoors in the morning. Make sure sidewalks and driveways aren't too slick. More significant ice accumulation to the west, and it lasts longer through Friday morning. Winter storm warning tonight through 3 p.m. tomorrow. It'll melt off before 3 p.m. for Rolla and Warrenton, Troy, Bowling Green, but you'll have a better chance for a little more significant ice. In fact, here's the ice accumulation. It's much less as you go to the east, and then 1/10 to a couple 1/10 of an inch across, especially the western side and northwestern side of St. Louis. What does that mean? It means slick spots are likely. This is a travel issue in the dark blue, less, but still isolated travel issues in the light blue here. Then you get into the pink, and I think it's deeper into the pink that you're going to notice a better chance for power outages and some tree branches snapping. But on the fringe, it's not out of the question. It's less likely, but that does mean Bowling Green, Troy, Warrenton, down to Rolla, parts of Gascony County. We'll be watching for that. Definitely a more significant travel issue before it all melts off. Probably mid to late morning farther to the west and northwest, but around 7 a.m. on in St. Louis, conditions should improve greatly as we head to a high of 36 above freezing and a few lingering rain showers in the afternoon. Now Saturday we have a chance for some light rain and snow, temperatures above freezing, so no travel issue there. Might see in some spots minor buildup on some grass. Otherwise that passes without too much fanfare. It is going to be a cold day though Saturday at 37. Here comes the warming trend, 40s on Sunday and near 50 by next week.
Steve, thank you so much. Here are some of the news stories making headlines today.
Jeffrey Amick, 42 years of age. Dorian Sims, 27 years of age.
It's important for all of us here today on this last day of the year to remember the loved ones who we so tragically lost in 2020.
Tonight was the annual candlelight service to remember St. Louis homicide victims from 2020. There have been 262 homicides in St. Louis this year, the most since 1993, and the highest number ever per capita on record for the city. A former church employee in St. Louis County has been charged after allegedly threatening to shoot up the church after being asked to wear a mask. 29-year-old Timothy Taylor was fired from Radiant Life in Christ Church in Jennings last month. Investigators tell us Taylor left after the outburst and returned to sit in the church parking lot several times. He also allegedly sent threatening texts to the co-worker who requested he wear a mask, threatening that co-worker's family. When Taylor was arrested just across the street from the church, he had 3 loaded guns in his possession. That is your News 4 update. Remember, we're always on at KMOV.com and on your KMOV News app.